I don't know. It's an odd day. It's already like practically lunch, and it's like, you know, the morning only for me. I guess I've been working late, but I want to talk about Aim to Please. Now, oddly, when I first stated it, it was Aim to Please itself, but really, really the gist of what I wanted to talk about is Aim to Please others and where it comes from. And it's an anxietal state. It's a definite anxietal state, and I believe it's brought on by often more than not the male species to women, the aim to please. Okay, so because men are bringing this anxiety to women, whether they're the fathers, whether they're the lovers, the husbands, whatever, aim to please. Jump, you know, it's that same jump, you know, now, because I said so, because you're stuck in this syndrome, jump now because I said so. I'm like, well, I'm never ever going to have a decent relationship with any man because I feel like I'm on fire coals that I must jump. And the reason is, why, I can go back and I can have regressions and go, I hate my upbringing as the fault. My upbringing, you know, because it was the jumper upbringing, you know, make her jump, make her, you know, the aim to please self or else. And here I am now, you know, I'm older and I'm like, well, I don't want to be this aim to please self. And thusly, you know, I'm doing what I wanted to do, and because I'm doing what I wanted to do, and things happen, like the police are being called at me. And so I'm like, well, I'm not aiming to please, you know, so if I do not aim to please, I end up in an, you know, it's almost like the trained dog, you know, that you have the trained dog who is used to, no, she jumps when, you know, she jumps when I say so. And when she's not jumping when I say so, then something is wrong. I'll call the police, I'll call the mental institutions. She is not jumping when I say so. She is not doing aim to please. So when I'm dealing with men having persnickeries, I'll say persnickeries, I'll have men having extravagant derogations, extravagant derogations of the female, of a female. I really, really am going into the fact that it is, she's not aiming to please any longer. For some reason, she's not aiming to please. He was used to that constance of rely. He was used to her being there, even in her most anxious state, even stumbling, tripping to get at his whatever, you know, his location. Whatever you want, I'm there, I'm listening. I'm here and I'm listening and I'm communicating. You know, the minute that stops, the aim to please is over. So when the aim to please is over, something is heinously wrong. It's like when we go into, I'll go into, it's so easy to jump into Asians as the what do we call it, as a dialogue of example, because my gosh, they've been such an example, haven't they? You know, the geisha, you know, oh my gosh, and how women are just the pawns of place. You know, you put them here, they go dish the dinner, and then they're the pawns of place, and there are no talk back. There's none of that going on. It's just the absolute polite beg practically. And no, I don't even think begging. That doesn't even exist. It's just the have to. you know, that have to supply because of the dominant male. You have to be in that aim to please or else. So when aim to please is disrupted, we end up with, oh my gosh, well, we have finger pointing, we have name calling, we have aggression to any degree. And when I say aggression, that means exactly that. That means, something is wrong with her. By stating something is wrong with her because she's no longer aiming to please, you know. So yeah, I don't know how to remove aim to please from myself, actually. As much as I've tried, you know, I've had quite a long interim away from my relatives, and I've really tried to remove that jump, you know, jump when they call, jump when they want. But I don't know if I can, you know. I don't believe I can. I believe man always will have that. Gosh dang it, you know. And I'm like, well, maybe, you know, if I was a taller woman, if I was like 5'10" or something, maybe that would help, you know. I wouldn't have such a hot plate personality. So that makes me extremely unattractive. And when I'm thinking me, I'm like, well, I guess it's not just me. I guess it's a whole bunch of women are hot-plated, aren't they? They're hot-plated into their anxietal state because of man. Some man in their life, whether it's a father, a brother, husband, lovers, whatever, or the whole list of all of them, just hot-platers, sons, even their sons. So I'm like, well, what's the deal? You know, all these women are running around claiming they have some disease and dying, and for sure dying, after the claim. Well, the hot plate reason, you know, the hot plate reason. So here I am with no hot plate, which is funny because I really would prefer to have a hot plate rather than these microwaves. They're just... Who invented those sounds that emit from them? So yeah, I kind of just want to throw that out and get a hot plate. So that's like my big order in life is it for a $20 hot plate. So I feel a little bit like my Uncle Tommy. He was that way with them, you know, loving hot plates. So yeah, I'm a little bit that directional. But yeah, oh my gosh, well, what a shame, isn't it, that I've been ruined, in essence. I've been ruined, and I blame the male species. I've been absolutely destroyed and put into an anxietal state. Well, so what else was I going to talk about? Oh gosh. So the aim to please... have to, and then the disruption of it when you're not aiming to please. And it's almost like, well, there's a reason for what do you call it? Conflict. So there's conflict existing at that moment. When woman stops her constant give. So I don't know, spoiled, I guess. Spoiled in there, allow. Now I'm choking. Oh my god. Yeah, spoiled. So man has been spoiled for so many years. Just spoiled. Wow. I don't know how we're going to get out of this one. I don't know. Gosh, dang it. It's like so many days. I'm like, I wish I was a heroin junkie. I just wish. I wish I had supply. Oh, you have no idea. You have no idea. I just want out. Yeah, they aim to please anxiety givers. They're just killing me.